Hey guys, I'm Alexandus. Welcome back for some more X Rebirth. We're going to be picking up where we left off after the first video. So we're going to be heading over to a freighter that we have. So to get there, we're going to have to hit up this space highway over here. So we're going to hit thrust, and we're going to pick ourselves up and get over here as fast as we can. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this first look at this game. I know I am very much. So then we're going to just jump in here, and we'll be good to go. Alright, so you see that on the bottom we have the leave highway lane thing again. And just try to pick up speed. We're going to just kind of sit here with everyone else. Alright, I thought they were going faster than that. Oh, they got stuck behind the freighter. Always, like on the highways, you're going to get stuck behind the slow cars. But I just think that this effect is absolutely amazing. It's almost like a little bit of a mini game, just to try to get through as fast as you can, but... And then we're gonna hit Z and pop on through. Entering distant fume. Apparently I can press F5 and save my game, which I'm gonna do that right now. So there we go, game is saved, not a problem. And it looks like if you kind of pitch the ship a little bit, it'll kind of flatten you out there, so that there is a kind of baseline on what is considered up and down with the game, which is good in its own way. That is a giant ship. What is that? That is a Ion's Harvester. So if you click on the ship, it'll kind of give you some basic information on the display here. The storage capacity, so obviously it has a lot of stuff in there. And this is one of those games where...
Object information added to ship computer database.
What was I thinking? From what I saw the previews of it, when you destroy a ship, if it's a civilian ship, like if you want to play a pirate character, you're going to mess up the economy in some way, shape, or form. There's going to be consequences for doing that. So we're going to hop in behind this ship here, try to get ourselves through just a little bit faster to get us through to the new sector. There we go. So we're gonna. I guess you'd call it space drafting. It's the only other way I know how to describe it. All right. So here
Looks
we
like
are.
The Sovereign Syndicate is causing trouble.
In the new
We'd
sector.
We best keep our distance. Take a look at the map to check where they're heading.
Okay. So how do I try to get behind targets and stay there to be safe from enemy fire? So there is some sort of armed conflict going on here. And I don't know if that's why all these ships are kind of hanging out here in the back, or what is going on. But let's try to see what's going on here. You can see all these civilian ships and civilian freighters trying to get to their destination. And they each do have a purpose. This is not like those standard games where any ship just kind of can mean nothing, and destroying it just means you get some loot and that's about it. You're actually messing up the economy in some way, which is...
Station information added to ship computer database.
No, shut up, Betty.
Alright, so that must have been a pirate ship there, if you saw that. Flying through. Stations get you discounts and commissions. So you kind of see the ships. I don't know if they're trying to avoid the fight just like I'm supposed to, or what. So, and what is... also great is we're gonna cut the engines down. You can see the conflict there in the distance going on, but alright, so we have, so basically WASD are your thrusters, I've been discovering here. So Q&E pitches the ship and you can fly through. This is all one fluid piece, and there's a police ship. You can kind of see that there, see the little lights on them, and then they're scanning vessels, checking their cargo, looking for anything, I'm guessing, you know, illegal. As I was saying before, you can fly through these ships. This is not like one static object where there's invisible barriers. Kind of hear the sirens, see the glow of the light. Just amazing effects. They did a fantastic job with this game. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to power up the thrusters, and we're going to get ourselves out of here so we can continue. We don't want to get caught up in that conflict at all, because I don't believe this puppy's ready yet for fighting. Or if it is, I don't know about it yet, because I'm sure there'll be a point where we're going to have to fight and defend ourselves. But overall, I'm just in love with this game. The effects of it are absolutely amazing. We're going to get in here so we can try to get through faster. And we're getting ready to jump out of this highway. There we go.
Entering Cuspid Splint.
All right, so next we need to go to the frozen circuit, which we're going to have to hop into this space highway. So we're going to be just sort of jumping from highway to highway to get to our destination. Which is also a great feature in the previous X games. Like I said, I'll be making a lot of comparisons between the two. There were no space highways. There was no quick way of getting from point A to point B. There was a jump drive, but it wasn't anything like this.
Frozen circuit.
All right, so I believe that is our ship. The green icon, you can see that, means that it is a friendly target. And we're going to check out this little transition point here. You can see all these civilian ships. Unprecedented as far as the scale and scope. Look at the highway. Absolutely amazing. It's amazing to see this. So if you can imagine playing this game as a pirate, someone that really has no care in the world for life, you can just go through and just start shooting all these ships. And you can just see it stretches for literally miles. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to get to the ship so we can continue the storyline, but I just wanted to show that to you guys because I think that it's absolutely amazing, the level of detail that they've done with this game. So let's hit the thrust and we'll be on our way. And here we are. This looks like, I guess, our freighter here, 4 kilometers or 5 kilometers out.
There she is. I can't say I've used her for trading much. Never got around to finding a crew.
Were you expecting company? Are these drones yours?
No, I can't say they are. They're headed this way.
Looks like drones from the Sovereign Syndicate. Do you ever have a quiet day?
So now we have to destroy these drones. Great. Strafe using left, right, up, down to evade incoming fire. Hey, I need you to stop shooting my ship, sir. Please? Alright. There we go. So now we get to do a little bit of combat.
You're being hit.
Where? From where? I guess it's from the other drone. Let me try not to hit my own ship, because that would be, in fact, deadly. Come on. We can do it. So it gives you a little bit of a targeting reticle, something to look at. I've almost got the one drone. I'm going to try to get in behind them here. There they are, much more maneuverable than I am. There we go, we got the one. Hopefully we don't get taken out here by the second.
Saving our station from those raiders was rather heroic.
Yes, I realize that. That's alright, so we gained reputation for some of these people. I don't know who that was that I gained reputation with, because I don't think that was my own personal faction that I had to gain reputation with. And this guy, is he running from me? Come on. Let me try getting a little bit closer here. There we go. Now we're lighting him up, and he's destroyed. Damaged weapons have reduced effectiveness, so I'm guessing maybe is my weapon damage or something?
You should move the ship. A boarding party may be on the way.
Engineers, I guess they saw a ship just sitting here and thought it would be an easy steal.
We should check the nearby stations. There are usually pretty capable freelance captains ready to take charge of a ship.
Let me guess. You know just the guy.
Not specifically, but I think I can point you in the right direction.
Saving our station from those raiders was rather heroic.
Thanks. Okay, so we can check our freighter status info by 2, property owned by 2. Ah, so then this will kind of bring us around. This is amazing. Okay, so let's see. So the Rahanis is the name of our freighter here. Property menu shows an overview of ships owned by you. I guess I can hit enter on it. Encyclopedia, Rahanis Container and Energy. Rahanis Energy Freighter, one of the capital ships of the Rahanis line of vessels, based on common ground design, just like its siblings. Vessel has only basic weapons and is neither very agile nor capable of fast acceleration. Okay. So, let's see what we've got here. Capacity is 130,000. Not as big as the other ship I think earlier that we saw, but that's okay. It does have a jump drive, so there is that still technology. I guess we'll be seeing that later on. Alright, looks good enough to me. So, let's go back. And let's see what we can do here. What does, 3-in-1 navigation. Let's show the galaxy map. Okay, This map shows a geographical overview of the galaxy. You can change the level of detail between galaxy, sector, system sector, and zone. Okay. So we have to go here, I'm guessing. Zone level shows ships, some of which you can contact through comms. So we can plot a course. And we can fly to water gates. So I'm guessing this is where we have to go. So let's go ahead and hit the thrusters here. So we have to go and fetch a captain for our giant freighter.
Looks like the database is missing info on local objects. You should be able to gather information on objects like stations.
And so we're almost to Watergate. Oh, here we are.
Watergate.
So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna very quickly fly the cuspid splint area. And we're gonna fall in right behind the freighter. Here we go.
You should be able to gather information on objects like stations when you pass nearby. There are sometimes opportunities to find different.
Okay. So basically, whenever we find a station, we want to try to fly past it. So now we want to dock at this station and try to navigate through this flow of traffic. So what do we have here? You know, when a comm link was selected, ship by pressing C. Industrial surveillance craft. So I don't know if that's like a local police or probably not. So let's try to get over here to this area. We can go ahead and dock at the station. Again, a new feature with the X series of games that you could not do before was physically walk around stations. You could dock with them, but you couldn't physically walk around at all in pretty much anything. So, again, yet another excellent feature of this. Self-fab matrix.
You should dock and look for a captain.
Okay, I would like to do that. So, can we fly near this little eye point? Let's press space. Deactivate steering mode. So, this kind of shows general information about the ship. That's nice. I would... What? Why is there a police ship here? So you can kind of see the little local police ships doing their local patrols and everything that it is that they do. I don't think that this is the docking point, so I'm going to go ahead and go forward. So this must be it.
This is the Albion Skunk.
Go ahead and dock.
Requesting permission to dock.
Docking permission granted.
Perfect.
Delightful to see you aboard. Don't be shy. Try speaking to someone.
Don't believe everything they say, especially if it's about how qualified they are. If I'm ever looking to hire someone or get a good deal, I usually try to sweet talk them.
Okay. So, talk to people. Some can be hired, others unlock rewards. So here we are. We're docked inside the station. Kind of get a good 360 view of our own ship here, which looks absolutely amazing. You can see another ship docked over there for effect. But of course, this is called the Albion Skunk. You can kind of see that there. So it's got a neat little hull detail. Excellent detail on the ship itself. So we're going to go ahead and go inside the station, see if we can find ourselves a freighter captain.
Watch out for containers packed with goodies. If it's not locked or nailed down, grab it.
What's wrong with you?
If you don't mind getting dirty, take a look in the vents too.
Okay, so I'm wondering if... Press space to jump. Great. Hold control to crouch. So we've got basic commands. Hey, look at that loader vehicle. I wonder if we can get in that. If I could, that would be absolutely hilarious. I don't think I can, though. It looks like that you might be able to for some things. I don't know. Maybe at a later time. So I'm guessing this could be a business contact since she's got the briefcase. She's an arms dealer, so that'd be good. Do some gun running, as it were. So let's go ahead and Hey, what's up? What's going on, dude? I guess you'd probably shoot me in the face. Okay. Let's see what's going on in here. Wow, look at all this. So we've got some business opportunities here. Looks like there's always a way to make money, which is great. Trade district, secured area. Administration, that area is all blocked off for now. Another loader. So an excellent, actually a very impressive level of detail with these stations. Just you can kind of see all the lights and everything. So let's see, trade district, secured area. So we want to go in here, our icon is right here. We're going to talk to that person. So let's see what this person does.
They didn't even have highways just 40 years ago.
And that is pretty amazing, because it was painful to navigate before then. So let's go ahead and talk to this person.
I'm all yours, buddy.
Okay, so let's see. Show me your skills.
Show me your skills, please.
Sure, let's do it.
So you have absolutely no idea. All right. So, let's see. A police chief, huh? All right, I'm not really worried about that right now. Let's go ahead and say they want to hire him. Current balance is 200,000, and they cost 10 grand to hire, so it looks pretty good.
Hiring me was a damn smart move, sir.
I didn't really see a way to sweet talk them at all, actually.
Stop and chat. I'll make it worth your visit if you shop here.
Nice, I'll pass. Chat.
Not.
Yeah, sorry. I'm really sorry. So let's go ahead and let's get back to the ship. Is there like a, what is this? I guess that's an elevator of some sort. Let's go ahead and go through here. I guess we have to just go back the way we came. Emergency exit. Well, it's not really an emergency, but I will take it as an exit. And there is no sprint mechanic, even though it does really feel like I'm sprinting already.
What's with all the AI fuss?
I'm kind of curious if you get like information from him or anything like that. He looks like he's got a disease that I want no parts of having. Let's just go on back to our starship. Which looks magnificent. So let's see if there's anything else. I wonder if anything else gets added to the ship over time. Anything like that. Doesn't look like it. And we just walk through that door, because that's what we do. Alright, so we're back here in the ship. For some reason the seat didn't move, but that's okay. And it looks like we've undocked, so we have to fly back to the frozen circuit. So my guess is that we're going to go ahead and take our new freighter captain that we hired and deliver her to the freighter so that she can begin operations. And what is that? Crew and equipment carrier. So for some reason, they're an enemy crew and equipment carrier. I don't know what considering what would make them an enemy other than maybe reputation or anything like that. So let's just go ahead and get in here. Go ahead and hit tab, speed this up a little bit. And here we go.
The computer can store information on this zone as well as trade offers on stations. There are sometimes opportunities to find
Entering frozen circuit.
Alright. So basically once we get that information on a station, it's gonna have essentially we'll be able to find trade deals, things like that. We can probably do some mining here if I really wanted to, which we'll probably end up doing here in a second, which is why the ship is in an asteroid, just my guess. But let's go ahead and speed up. And we'll be able to deliver this freighter captain so that she can basically start her new job. Find a dock on your trade ship to dock at. Okay, so I guess I have to go over here, because I did see the dock icon.
Dock location added to ship computer database.
There we go.
This is the Albion Skunk, requesting permission to dock.
So for some reason, the animation's completely froze up on the ship, but that's okay. You call your captain with the main menu 5-2 and tell him or her to work here. Okay, so let's go to the main menu. Crew. Call remotely. Our new captain.
Hiya.
And work here.
Starting new station assignment, sir. I won't be a disappointment.
And very good. So, she is now a part of this ship, and I'm curious if there's anything else that we can get. There's Talladium paneling. I'm taking it really from my own ship. Interesting. Okay. So other than docking here, is there anything that I can do? I'm guessing not. So what's in here? Entertainment consoles, mining equipment. I feel like I'm looting my own ship and I shouldn't be doing that. Alright, so I think this is pretty much everything that we're going to be able to do other than just loot all of this stuff from our own vessel. So I'm going to go ahead and end it here. This is still an excellent start. Can't wait to find out what's going on with the story as far as the storyline mode in the campaign. So thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to share the video with your friends and check the game out for yourself. It's on Steam now. And if you're not a subscriber, become one today. Remember guys, you're awesome. I'll see you later.